Through it all, I stay the same. I swear to God, I can't lie. Been down so damn low that I came up from my life.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome king, fighting out of the red corner, Floyd Masson. Perfect composure when I scream at the chauffeur. I ain't mean I'm just focused. Put a lean out slower, got us clean out of soda. Before the flood, people judge, they did the same thing to Noah. Everybody wanted Yandy, that Jesus Christ did the laundry. They say that we start on Monday, but the strong start on Sunday. Won't be in bondage to any man. John 8:33. We the descendants of Abraham. Yeah, you should be made free. John 8:36. To whom the sun set free is free indeed. He say the rich like me. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Discipline. You cannot run your demons. They'll always find you. Only way to beat them motherfuckers is look at them eye to eye.
Think I'm playing chess, I see a king, I'm at his neck. I'm 3 steps ahead of every move, now that's a check. Think I'm playing chess, I see a king, I'm at his neck. I'm 3 steps ahead of every move, now that's a check. Yes, no one know my secret, it's because I never slept.
And boxing out of the blue corner, his opponent, please welcome Joe Liga.
Hey, what I told him, I said, being hot gets you the MVP. Staying hot gets you the Hall of Fame. Slow, slow.
Brooklyn fam.
Smyrna, what up, son? Brooklyn, what up, son?
Yeah.
I hit my smutty dance when I cut the lick. I hit my smutty dance when I cut the chick. I Bobby Smurda that when she came around. Threw that hat up in the air, never came down. And I just caught that body like a week ago. We can go real quick, click, clack, get the freaking out. You want some hot nigga chilling out and meek enough? Or dot niggas all summer and ain't meek enough? I ain't no killer, but don't push me up. I had them killers in your bushes, yo. Them trick niggas splurge on the pussy, yo. You give me one day, I purge on that pussy, yo. You ain't seen these kicks since like the fifth grade. Back when Bo Jackson and King Griffey played. On my 90s flow, nigga, young OG shit. On my GSC, meet the family shit.
Ladies and gentlemen, fight five on tonight's card. It's all on the line. Ace Boxing Promotions presents the Australasian Cruiserweight title. This bout is sanctioned by the Australian
National Boxing Federation, represented by the supervisor, Mr. John Hogg, here today. Also in our corner, Dr. James Conville, our medico ringside, with Phil Austin, the man on the bell. The judges, Mr. Alan Burford, Mr. Rod Marsh, and Mr. Paul Williams. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing to you, fighting out of the red corner, this man comes from Eastside Boxing, where he's looked after by Frankie Pianto. He's prepared, he's ripped, he's ready. He weighed in at 90.3 kilos, and he's wearing the black trunks. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Floyd Masson. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent in the blue corner, he stands ready to battle. He comes from the shape lip boxing under the guidance of Jeff Fraser. He's ripped too. He's ready. He loves the fight game. He weighed in at 88.6 kilos for this cruiserweight title fight. He's wearing the white trunks. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Joe Liga. Ladies and gentlemen, 10 by 3 rounds of championship boxing. Your referee, Mr. Paul Tapley, he's the third man in the middle. We're ready to go. Fight five, it's all on the line.
You're watching All On The Line, presented by Ace Boxing Group. This is the Australasian Cruiserweight title. Oh boy, this is going to be a beauty, this one. Floyd Masson in the black trunks out of Eastside Boxing, coached by Frankie Pianto in the red corner. He's undefeated up against Joe Liga. In the white trunks in the blue corner out of Shape Up Boxing, trained by Jeff Fraser. Liga versus Masson here for the Australasian Cruiserweight title.
Yeah, first title fight for Floyd, but something tells me after looking at his previous fights, he's right up for it. The boys will be fighting for national honours in the Cruiserweight division. But we'll see, soon see a new phase for Floyd Masson in his career, because if he needs to get to the heights where he wants to reach, he will need to dispose of Joseph Liga here, and he's a tough competitor, that's for sure. Liga, he's been in there with the who's who of Australian boxing. Had a tough night out last time out, up against the powerhouse Luke Medini, going inside three rounds. But other than that, he's been a tough task for everyone and won majority of his fights.
Really nice counter there too by Liga, but it's Masson working Liga around the ring here early on.
Yeah, he's dictating with his feet once again, cutting off the ring really well. He does that really well. Cuts the ring off, forces his opponents to the corners and to the ropes, and then he unloads that big left hand that he has.
Both men in tip-top shape here.
Yeah, Masson just stalking his opponent, zapping his energy, just without even throwing a punch, just that energy that gets zapped just from the physical presence of somebody being in front of you is enormous. Doing that very well here, Floyd Masson.
And here he goes now, Masson. He's got Liga where he wanted. He's very patient. Now Liga, his own, had Masson on the ropes here momentarily.
The second fight for Floyd this year as well, after he dismantled Kato Felafahi inside three rounds back in March on another Ace Boxing card. So second bout for the year for him.
Oh, have a look at this. Liga's taken matters into his own hands there.
A rugby league tackle.
He said, I've had enough of this, Floyd. Boom. We're back into it now, though.
Launching in with that big right hand, missing the mark there, Liga, but very patient is Floyd Masson.
Work out of it, work out. Right, step back, step back, step back.
And already showing a battle scar.
Yeah, and he's cut over his left eye there, and that's going to be a first for him as well. So another little obstacle for him to deal with here tonight.
As Joe Liga really finishing this round strongly.
Oh, good shots there from Masson on the bell to the body of Liga.
Well, Joe Liga certainly had his moments at the back end of the first. Crowd still recovering from that performance we just saw from that auctioneer during the interval.
Yeah.
But what a way to follow up here. Liga and Floyd Masson. And, well, we were talking about Floyd just exerting that energy early on from Liga in the opening exchanges, but Liga really finished well.
He did. He did finish well, and he's come to fight. Like I said, he's not one of those guys that are just going to hand over the win to Masson. He's here to win. And Liga, you can see he's already marked up very badly, but he's also caused a cut to Masson, which is the first of his career as well. So, like I said, there's layers to this game, and he's just unraveled one more layer that he has to deal with here tonight, which is all going to add to his experience.
They're not short on confidence, Masson's corner, are they?
Definitely not. They know what they've got. They've got a potential superstar. He is very, very good, Masson. But like I said, to get onto those bigger scalps, he needs to get through Joe Liga here tonight.
Joe Liga certainly will have a say in proceedings tonight. Just quickly, Nath, who got the first round in your eyes?
I'd still give it to Masson. He just had the better shots, the cleaner shots. I understand there was a really good period at the end there for Liga, but the cleaner shots came from Masson. But as I say that, Liga just scores with his own really good clear shot as well. Oh, and a good right hand there by Liga as well.
Don't hold his head down, Joe.
He's owning this first period of the second round.
Liga, oh, have a look at that. Well, interesting from Liga. Really using his body weight to his advantage, Joe Liga.
Definitely so, and you can see him riding, almost rolling with the punch, and then coming back with a big right hand. So he's using all of his weight behind his punches, which is great.
Lovely 1-2 from Masson, but Liga then scoring off the counter before Masson responded again. Here goes Masson.
Don't hold his head down, Joe.
He's doing everything he has to do, Liga, here. He's making it rough and dirty. Like I called for some of the earlier fights tonight, this is what you have to do. To spoil the party, you need to get in their face and throw punches, and that's what Liga's doing here tonight, and he's hitting him and wobbled him with a couple of those right hands.
Yep, really having some success off that little short in under uppercut is Liga. And Masson does pack a punch though, doesn't he?
He definitely does. He's very crisp in his shots. And Liga can't get off the accelerator here because any opening and Masson will take care of him.
Get your heads out of it.
Stakes are high here. The Australasian Cruiserweight title on the line. 45 seconds remaining here in the second.
Keep him up.
10 three-minute rounds in this one. A long way to go.
Don't hold his head down.
Oh, huge right there from Floyd Masson.
Keep him up.
And both boys, when they get close, they've got to keep on working there. They can't just have a break. They've got to keep working in close. Especially over these longer distance rounds, you need to be able to zap the energy and take it out of your opponent. And you can do that by hitting the body in close.
Intriguing round two there. And, well, Floyd Masson, he comes in here with big raps, Nathan, but he's certainly got a fight on his hand here tonight.
Oh, he does. And Liga always puts up a good show. That's for certain. So, but, yeah, Masson, if he didn't think he was in a fight before this, he certainly does know now, because Liga has come for one thing, and that's to get the W. As he throws down, you can see some of these replays. There's some big shots. They would knock out other people.
Thanks to UltraTune. Ultra Tune, one of our major sponsors here tonight, alongside the Australian Health Professionals and Pivotal Homes. There's Floyd Masson and Joe Liga. Round three. This round starting much like the first, with Masson just moving Liga around the ring early on.
Yeah, dictating with his feet once again, just pushing him to the corners. But he needs to throw something with it. There it is. Both boys just happy to pick their shots in these early stages of the third round. You can see Liga trying to balk something out of Masson with his foot tap there, trying to draw something out of him so he can counter. He's very good counter puncher, Liga. Good jab.
And there he comes in with the counter here, Liga, picking his moment. Floyd Masson continues to try and force Liga on the ropes. Liga now, central ring position.
Yeah, both boys equal amount of experience, both fighting in their 10th professional fight here tonight.
On that occasion, it was Masson with the counter. Who have you got the more powerful puncher out of these two, Nathan?
I would have to sway towards Masson, but he hasn't landed clean yet, whereas Liga has, so that's why you're probably getting stirred. But here's a couple of clean shots here, as I just say that, by Masson. He starts to pour on the energy now. Oh, big shot to the body. He's trying to find that headshot as well to go along with it.
Liga doing well here to evade a lot of this flurry, but what a moment here in this fight for Floyd Masson. Wonderful combination we saw then. And Floyd Masson getting on top here in this third round, only 15 seconds remaining.
Yeah, he's got to close it out. He's got to keep the pressure on here. Big left hand just missing the mark there from Masson. Liga survives
the round. Well, he did exactly that, Nathan. He finished very strongly there. Floyd Masson, huge left to finish. And perhaps the most emphatic of the three rounds going the way of Floyd Masson and what we just saw.
No doubt. I mean, he's sitting on right now at 67% knockout ratio. So he's definitely got kryptonite in both hands, that's Masson. And we can see that towards the later end of that third round. When he presses the go button, he's got plenty of power, and that's what he's going to do. He's going to follow that up now in the fourth round, and he could close this out. Big shots there towards the last 10 seconds of that third round.
Highlights thanks to Australian Health Professionals. Floyd Masson, still undefeated, looking for that 10th win in his professional career. As you said, both fighters, this is their 10th fight. The Australasian Cruiserweight title on the line. Masson straight into it from the opening bell.
That's what he's going to do. You can't let him rest and gain some confidence back, Liga. He's going to go right on with it here.
Put your heads in there.
Good shot there from Masson on the back foot, a hook.
A lot of
ferocity in those punches from Masson.
Yeah, and he's got him where he wants to. He's bullying him to the corner and back to the ropes. So if he throws more than one punch, he's got him right where he wants him to be.
Oh, here's Liga opening up.
Good shots and good little exchange there from Liga as well.
Well, this very much still anyone's contest.
Pick him up, pick him up.
Both boys try and work to the body when they're in close. That was a good right hand over the top from Liga.
Just trying to weather the storm here, Liga.
Let him go.
Counter when he can. Keeping it much closer to Masson. Here is Joe Liga, yep, looking to get in tight.
Exactly what he needs to do.
Looking for that left. Oh, here we go. A little 1, 2, 3, 4 there from Joe Liga.
You can see Mason's strategy. He's trying to hit away to the head to draw up the arms of Liga so he can sink in one of those body shots. You watch him closely here and taps away at the head and trying to look for that opening in the body, but Liga finds another good shot himself.
Stop!
Gee, that was a little low.
Keep
there from Masson.
Keep him up. Box.
Yeah, referee Paul Tapley picks him up. There he is, tapping away, tapping away. Oh, and oh, the clubbing left hook.
He's in trouble here, Liga.
He's in massive trouble. There he is, he sinks to the canvas for the second time. He's in all sorts here, Joseph Liga.
Welcome me, step aside.
Masson moves in, it's all over.
Yeah, the end was near, and that is game over. Floyd Masson, when he smelt the blood, he was able to take it out.
Floyd Masson, clinical, moves in, stalks his prey, times it to perfection. The perfect 10 for Floyd. And an Australasian Cruiserweight title to go along with it.
Yeah, he'll learn more from that fight than his previous nine. That was a hard fight. Even though he'll score the KO victory on his record, that was by far his hardest test. Liga gave him plenty to look at all the way through that fight and rocked him a couple of times himself. So he'll take a lot out of that fight, Floyd Masson. And picks up his first title along the way as well to go with it.
I thought for a moment Joe Liga was going to land in your lap, Nathan.
That was a big shot. I was worried about that too, let me tell you.
You spoke about Floyd Masson off air. You got big raps on him. For viewers at home, Nathan, what is it that you like so much about Floyd?
Well, he's a big boy that knows how to box. That's the biggest thing. He's you can see he's got every punch in the book. And he's very composed. He usually does it at his own pace. He draws the opponent down to his pace, and he can do that because of his superior boxing quality. So he is a very, very, very great boxer, and he's a big boy. And that's usually, those two things don't come in the same sentence. So that's why I think he's got a big future, and he's with the right team now. Frankie Pianto, he moved from Western Australia, where he struggled to get fights, now to Queensland, where there's obviously a lot more active fighters here. So he's made the move, he's made the sacrifices. So the world's his oyster now.
The world is his oyster indeed, and lovely to see him go over and just congratulate and check on Joe Liga. Floyd Masson moves to 10-0. KO victory over Liga. As we look to make it official shortly, Floyd Masson and Joe Liga, with Floyd Masson victorious. Just another night at the office for Floyd. I know Ace Boxing Group Very excited about this man. You're watching All on the Line, presented by Ace Boxing Group, thanks to UltraTune, Australian Health Professionals, and Pivotal Homes. Here's our MC.
Steel Ryan coming in to present the belt. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for both combatants here in this Australian Cruiserweight title fight, Joe Liga and Floyd Masson. Ladies and gentlemen, the decision, a knockout, 2 minutes, 58 seconds into the fourth round. Only 2 seconds would have meant a break. The new Australian Cruiserweight champion from the red corner, Floyd Masson.
Floyd Masson, the new Australasian Cruiserweight champion.
Floor product, Steel Ryan, puts the belt on the champ. Very quickly, Floyd, a few words, mate. You must be over the moon.
Yeah, I'm really happy. Let's get this out. It's been a really long camp and put a lot of work into it, and I'm just glad it paid off tonight.
It certainly did, mate, and I didn't know what was going to happen. You know, two tough blokes in there, and one punch was going to make the difference, and you got it.
Yeah, no, I'm just happy. I just thought as soon as I got cut, it kind of took me a bit off my game plan, but I just thought if I keep a bit of a pace, I'll be able to catch him.
Good opponent, Joe Liga.
Yeah, 100%. Full respect to Joe Liga for taking the fight. He's an absolute champion, and take my hat off to him.
All right, mate. Enjoy the moment. Ladies and gentlemen.
I'd just like to thank all my sponsors for coming out and supporting me and all the supporters. And go to Armin's Butchers for a big ribeye steak.
Floyd Masson, the Australian Cruiserweight champion, Australasian. Give me a big hand as he makes his way out of the ring. Our new Australasian Cruiserweight title champion, Floyd Masson.